Welcome to Pack TV. I'm Shiloh.
And I'm Ashlyn, and today is Monday, October 2nd.
Sadie's is 1 month away, and the theme is the great outdoors, so you can wear your camo and your camping gear. Go, so ladies, start asking and start planning.
Students, your pictures from homecoming are in the main office. They don't want to store them anymore, so if you haven't picked them up, please go pick them up.
This is an announcement for all teachers. There will be a mandatory meeting tomorrow at 2:45 regarding the school bond. It will be held in the auditorium.
And this is just a shout out to our custodians because we do really appreciate all their hard work. If you see one, tell them thanks and give them a high five because this week is Custodian Appreciation Week.
So you didn't make it to the book fair, but you really wanted to buy some books. You can still shop online for a few more days. All you have to do is head up to the library and get the URL from the librarians.
The ASVAB test for the military placement will be on November 1st. If you're interested in taking this test, please see Lisa Burton in the CTE office to sign up.
Weber State will be here this Thursday during Flex for a group advising session. They will be talking about concurrent enrollment classes that may best fit you and your needs. See Lisa Burton in the CTE office for more information.
And over to the news desk.
Guys, so last week Twitter started testing their 280 character tweets within a small group, and it's to help users who tweet in Spanish, English, French, Portuguese to be more expressive when they tweet. Right now, it's, like I said, it's only being tested within a small group. Hopefully the rest of the Twitter users can see that change when they tweet.
That's way cool. So last night, more than 50 people were killed and at least 400 others were injured after a gunman opened fire on a country music festival near the Mandalay Bay Resort in Las Vegas. Las Vegas PD reported the death toll via Twitter last night in the early hours of the morning, and the suspect, 64-year-old Stephen Paddock, was killed after a SWAT team came into his hotel room where he was firing on the crowd. The police believe that it was a solo act and that he is no longer a threat. Thanks, guys.
Our thoughts and prayers go out to all those who were involved. Stirling Scholar applications are due in just a few weeks on October 13th, so seniors, if you are interested in becoming a Stirling Scholar, please talk with your teachers or see Mr. Checkitz in room B214.
And those seniors interested in the dance Stirling Scholars need to pick up an application outside the dance studio ASAP. Tryouts for this are Tuesday the 10th.
Also, those who are interested in the business Stirling Scholar, please go to Pollard's room and pick up an application form.
And for those students who are part of the DECA or interested in DECA, there's a DECA meeting tomorrow in the lecture hall during Flex. You need to see Pollard to get a DECA Flex pass for this.
This year's NHS induction is next Thursday, October 12th. Dinner for this occasion will be served at 6 p.m. and the ceremony will begin at 7. Please pay for your ticket, which is $12 to the bookkeeper, by tomorrow.
HOSA is having a blood drive this Wednesday. You must be at least 16 years old to donate, and you must have a permission slip turned in to Mr. Cap by tomorrow. These slips are in Cap's, Harold's room, or Eisenberg's room.
Hey, this is... Oh, my God. Okay. This Wednesday is a blood drive, and... God. Why is this so hard?
I don't know.
Why is...
Students, the deadline for the Scary Story Contest is only a few weeks away.
Hi, my name is Juice, and today we are at the Fremont High with the Ghost Hunters. There have been reports that there is a ghost inside of Fremont. There has been paranormal activity, and they have been riding the wolves, and he says he's a very pale-faced man, so we're going to figure out today. There have been rumors in the theater department that he is here in the auditorium. His name is Juanita. Have you seen the ghost of Fremont?
No.
Bullocks. Here we have another student of Fremont High. Excuse me, miss. Have you seen the ghost of Fremont?
Yes.
You see them too? She sees them too.
I would have gotten away with it if it wasn't for you meddling kids.
Join us next time at Ghost Adventures on Pack TV at Fremont.
Applications for the Scary Story Contest are in Miss Guyver's room. Now let's head over to Isaac for sports in the locker room.
Thanks, guys. Well, the football team
came up with a short this past Friday, and they lost 28-14. However, their eyes are low set for the big rival game against Weber this Thursday evening. The baseball team will be selling these awesome hats, and they would love to see everyone wearing them at this Thursday's football game.
Hey, Matt, did you go to the Northridge game?
Yeah, did you see Maddie Poban's curve slam?
Ooh, he got curved so hard.
Yeah, she looked like she was boxing out there, dodging all them punches.
Ooh, man.
Hey. Sorry to interrupt the important conversation that you two were having, but I had a question.
Yeah, what's up?
I noticed you're rocking these sweet camo hats, and I want to know where I can pick one up.
Well, they're $20. Pick them up from Nash or Clark, and they'll get you a deal.
Really? $20 only?
That's it.
Dude.
$20 for one of them.
Gang.
All week long, it's a farm in town. They're making that money grow. Tractors, plows with flashing lights.
The tennis team will be at the state tournament this Wednesday and Friday. Good luck to those ladies. The volleyball team has continued their winning streak with a victory over Clearfield last Thursday evening. They took on third-ranked team in the state, Syracuse, this Thursday evening. That game will be here in the Wolf Den. The cross-country team was in Park City this past weekend and had some great results. Zach and Bronson Winter took first and second overall, with Bryce Tolman finishing 11th. Meanwhile, Manzi Melling took third, and Megan Terry placed sixth in the women's race. Overall, there were 542 participants, and Fremont team represented well. Congratulations to those team. They have a region race this Friday against Layton. And today is cross country's fundraising night at Chick-fil-A on 12th Street. Between 5 and 9 p.m., go order some food and save Fremont Cross Country, and Fremont will get some money back on the meal that you purchase. The girls' soccer team had a bye last Thursday, but they are back in action tomorrow at Clearfield. The game is at 3:30. Finally, swim begins their tryouts today in Ogden High. That's it for sports. Back to you two.
Thanks, Isaac. For those who are planning on taking the ACT, there is an ACT prep class that will be held beginning October 16th. The cost will be $10. That can be paid to the bookkeeper.
And the Chalk Arts Festival that was supposed to happen a few weeks ago finally gets underway this Wednesday.
And for those who eat lunch here and have salad, it is now located in the deli line.
Newgate Mall is switching up their rewards program. You don't have to bring in receipts anymore. All you have to do is follow them on Facebook, take a picture in their photo booth, and post it with the hashtag Newgate Mall. When you do this, our school earns points, and points equals cash for the school.
And finally, seniors. Today during Flex is the senior panoramic picture. It's in the small gym. So at this time, teachers, you can release the seniors to head down there.
That's it for PAC TV.
Have a great day, Wolves.